Hi, my name is Ariana, and I have excoriation disorder. Just to preface this, if you struggle with depression, anxiety, or disorder, or some of those things might trigger you, this video is probably not for you. I don't want anyone to be upset by the contents, so if you think you might be uncomfortable, then please do click out, put your mental health first. So, if you don't know, excoriation disorder is classified in the DSM, which is what we in the US use to diagnose mental disorders, as a compulsive disorder. And basically, it is what the name says. You compulsively pick at your skin. And for me, I've had this disorder undiagnosed for many years, but I was officially diagnosed in March. Sorry, there's a dog barking. For me, where it started was, as far as I can remember, in middle school. I had always been a pimple popper and a pecker at my skin, but it didn't get really bad till about 8th grade. We had our 8th grade formal, and I'd gotten like this little aquamarine teal color strapless dress. And you could see my scarring. And my mom went out and she bought this really thick, heavy foundation meant for your body and legs, and used it to cover up all my scarring. And that was like one of the first times that I can remember my disorder really affecting me. Going on into high school, into college, it really continued to progress. It got to be, went from just like my chest and shoulders to down my arms, on my stomach, on my legs, back, really just everywhere, and did get worse with stress and all of the changes I was experiencing in my life. And then my last semester of college, a little bit after spring break, I kind of just snapped. I was really struggling with a lot, and my depression and anxiety really got the best of me, and I couldn't function. So to keep make a long story short, I visited my university's health clinic, where they have psychiatrists who can diagnose you and prescribe you medications. And the psychiatrist I met with diagnosed me with depression, generalized anxiety disorder, and of course, excoriation disorder. She also put me on 50 milligrams of sertraline. So, to kind of talk about where my disorder is right now, I hate to say that as far as medication, the biological method of treatment goes for me, treating my excoriation disorder has not really helped. It's helped tremendously with my depression and anxiety, but not what's going on here. And I'll insert some pictures of how my skin is right now. But it is pretty bad. It can be painful because you have a bunch of open sores on your arms and chest or whatever. I have so many scars. It looks like freckles on my skin. And that's really unfortunate. I try not to be super self-conscious about it. I don't cover up my scarring with makeup when I go out in public anymore, and I try to feel free to wear strapless clothing or clothing that's maybe more cut, low cut. But I still struggle in terms of intimacy. For example, my ex-boyfriend, I think my disorder was a little bit of a point of contention in our relationship. I think it made him very sad that I couldn't stop destroying my skin. And when it came to having sex, I felt really, really insecure. Even though I knew, like I knew deep down that he didn't care how my skin looked, I still felt ashamed. And I also think as I got older and I continued to have this disorder, it was very frustrating for me because I felt like I was failing myself. Like, I was not strong enough to overcome my disorder. I felt, and I still in some ways really do feel trapped. And even though I know, like, logically, sorry, it's a fuck. Even though I know logically that it's a disorder, it's a battle, and it's okay to keep fighting and to not always be winning, the more emotional side of me feels at times very defeated. Just very defeated because I feel like I should be doing better and I should, excuse me, be able to self-regulate and things like that. But I recognize that it's a process. And I'm trying to do better every day. Of course, I need to be seeking out some cognitive behavioral therapy as I'm heading into the summer. I don't have much to do. Summer months for me and my disorder are a little bit strange because on the one hand, there's lots of sun, which is good for my skin, but on the other hand, I have a lot more free time, which means my hands are open to be picking at my skin. So that's where I'm at right now. I guess why I'm making this is because I don't really have much of a community with other people who are going through similar things that I am. Here in Texas, or even back in DC where I go to school, it really is not, there's not very many people or anyone that I know that is experiencing the same thing that I am, and I think that kind of makes where I'm at seem a little bit darker. And I know that there are other people out there who have the same experiences as I do, and I want to be able to find those people and to talk to them and just share our stories and refine some strength through them. So if you or anyone you know has excoriation disorder or dermatillomania, please let me know or come talk to me, because that would be really nice and awesome. But yeah, thank you so much for listening.